With us now is the number 14 seed in our regional South Dakota State Jackrabbits with a record of 23-8, appearing in their sixth NCAA tournament and fourth in the last five seasons, and entered the tournament on an eight-game win streak. We will open with a comment from head coach Aaron Johnston, 15th season as South Dakota State head coach, winningest coach in program history, and then we'll follow with questions for the student athletes. Coach?
Well, it's great to be here. Appreciate the opportunity to be back in the NCAA tournament. We've had a good run, and a lot of that goes to having some really good players during that stretch. Hospitality's been great here so far. We're looking forward to getting on the court and practicing. Been preparing for what's going to be a very, very good opponent in Oregon State. They deserve a lot of credit for not only this year, but for really in a short period of time, kind of transforming their program from one that was I'm just struggling a little bit to now being one of the best teams in the Pac-12 and hosting the first round game here in the NCAA tournament. So congratulations to them. Be a good test and a fun way to get started here.
All right, thank you, Coach. Our student athletes today for the Jackrabbits are Macy Miller, Megan Waytashek, and Mariah Clarin. We'll now open questions for the student athletes. Right here.
Mark Overton, KDLT. I'll address this to you two guys, your seniors. Talk about the importance of not just getting here, but winning a game tomorrow.
Yeah, we've been here before. Well, Mariah and I have. And, you know, it's fun. It's a fun experience, but to make the most of the experience, it's going to be winning that first game and to advance in the tournament. So that was our goal, and that's what we're working towards tomorrow.
Yeah, we're just trying to do things that not many teams have done, and at least from our school. So winning a game is huge.
Gary Morris with the Statesman Journal for the players. If you talk a little bit about playing against a center like Ruth Hamlin, 6'6", and also the home court advantage that Oregon State clearly has here.
Yeah, she's a great player, watching film on her, but we've played players like that in the past. In our league, we have a 6'7 post, so we've had that matchup and we prepared for that, so that's definitely going to help us tomorrow.
And as well on the matchup of playing in Corvallis, home floor.
Yeah, but, you know, we've played in, you know, away games all season, and we have to travel to other home courts and played with their home court advantage, so we're prepared for that and looking forward to the experience tomorrow.
Mariah Peters from KSFY. It's been, you know, kind of a wild 72, 48 hours for you guys, not knowing when you're going to leave, where you're going to fly into, all logistics, traveling. Is that almost a disadvantage, not knowing, you know, flying into Portland and having to drive all the way down? Does that kind of put a wear on the body in a situation like this?
I don't really think so. I think we've been in situations like that. Last year, we played Green Bay and we had a bunch of travel issues, and we probably played one of the best games we played all season. So I don't really think we use that as an excuse. We just look to really show up at the game tomorrow.
Next question for the student athletes.
Matt Zimmer, Argus Leader. Mariah, in women's basketball NCAA tournaments, the 3-4 team matchup has traditionally been very, very bad for the 14. Is there any sort of reaction to that, or does it maybe almost give you guys a motivation to maybe change that a little bit? What's your thought on that history?
I think it's a lot of motivation. I mean, we work to break new records and try to start a new trend, so I think it's just pure motivation.
Further questions? In the back.
Scotty Quaz, Jackrabbits Sports Network. For Macy, being the newcomer, does this feel different, or does this feel like another game you're scouting and getting ready, or what does it feel as a newcomer to the NCAA?
As a newcomer, I'm a little nervous right now, but, you know, it's just another game, and scouting is just the same, and we're ready to take on Oregon State.
Mariah, you obviously went head-to-head with Vicky in the Sunday tournament. Megan kind of touched on earlier, how is kind of that past experience going to help you out, taking on a girl like Ruth, who's that same size, same kind of player?
Just making sure that I am seeing other players open on the floor and making sure our guards are attacking, and we're just really attacking her and trying to find the open player.
Down in front.
Megan, talk about Ellie and Macy in particular, what tremendous impact those two freshmen have had. The Oregon State coach talked about it earlier, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a drawback being a freshman. In fact, by this time of the year, no one's a freshman.
Yeah, our freshman class has been great all year. Ellie, Macy, Lexi, they've all had great contributions and have really progressed throughout the season. Confidence level's raising, and really excited to see what they do tomorrow and years to come.
Macy, obviously, you got a relative in Mike who's had a pretty big shot at the NCAA tournament game before. Have you remember seeing that shot? Has he said anything to you leading to your first NCAA tournament game?
Well, I really never got to watch him. I was a little too young. But, you know,
I'm sure you've seen it.
Nope, I haven't seen anything. And I don't know, just going to the NCAA tournament, just play with a lot of confidence and play with the team and just, you know, play as well as we can.
Mason, talk about what a crazy week it's been for your family in terms of a national championship game just a couple of nights ago, and here you are in Morgan.
It's been a really crazy week. My parents haven't been to work in a while. They were at the Summit League the past week, and they went right to Branson the next day to watch my brother, and he was in the national tournament, but they didn't win, but that's all right, and they'll be watching at home this week.
Further questions for our student athletes? All right, thank you. Thank you very much, ladies. Good luck. And now we will open up questions for Coach Johnston, right in the front.
Gina Mizell with the Oregonian in Portland. For those of us who have not watched you all season long, you mentioned the 8-game winning streak. Just what was the key to that stretch that really got you guys rolling and get that automatic bid?
Well, I think from our perspective is our team early in the year was very good offensively, and I think even during that 8-game stretch we were good offensively, but the big change was we were just much better defensively. We just didn't allow teams to play to their strengths on the offensive end of the floor. In our losses this year, the majority of them were all just defensive issues. Very rarely did we not score enough points to win. It was just a matter of not defending the way we really need to. So on the court, that was probably the biggest part of it. And I think internally, something we saw a lot of, we just got really, really good play from our senior class and our one junior, Chloe Korneman. That senior class and Chloe really, you know, found another gear as the season went on, really on both ends. And some of their roles are really big, like Megan Waytashek and Mariah starters, but Rachel and Chloe, a little bit more subtle in how important they were. And I just thought that leadership from those two classes was a big part of our effort and focus that we played with late in the year.
Question.
Yeah. Aaron, kind of what we were talking about earlier with comparing the size here to the size you faced in the Summit League tournament with Oral Roberts. I remember you mentioning after that game that you maybe wish you'd done some things differently early in the first half as far as attacking that. I assume that has affected your approach or your game plan coming into this one.
Yeah, I think so. You know, McIntyre's a really good player, you know, and I don't think she probably still gets enough credit nationally for how good she was. We'll see that kind of length inside. You know, with the first and second rotations, not just a one-time player here. And I think the other big difference with Oregon State, too, is their length on the perimeter. You know, one of the things we are in our league is really long on the perimeter. We'll start everybody 6 foot or higher, and in our league, that's a big difference. But now as you play Oregon State, I mean, that's their starting lineup, too, the 1-2-3. So the length inside is part of it, but then it's the length on the perimeter, just disrupting passes and everything. So we've got to find a way to spread people out a little bit more and do a better job of attacking the basket and then making extra passes, finding open people. We really talked about it can't be the first drive. It's got to be the second and third drive, maybe, that creates a shot. And I thought in the Summit League tournament against that size, we really tried so hard individually to get to the basket and just didn't play well enough as a team and moving the ball, extra pass kind of thing. So any of the offensive concepts we've worked on really have included that idea. Hopefully it's better. I think it was 12 blocks we had in the Summit League tournament. Not we had, 12 blocks we contributed to, so we'll have to do a better job with that.
Question?
David Brown, Midco Sports. This is the fourth time in your 6 appearances you're playing on the other team's home court. Is there a difference between a regular season road game and a tournament road game?
Oh, I think there's a difference between a tournament game and non-tournament game, absolutely. Being on the road in the tournament certainly makes it more difficult. But to be honest, we would prefer that. I mean, the neutral site idea is great, but sometimes you end up at the place that just has very little atmosphere. And I think any of us would take atmosphere over no atmosphere. Obviously, you want it to be on your side, and we get the benefit of that through our home games and in the Summit League tournament. But when it's on the other foot, we would absolutely take atmosphere over no atmosphere any day of the week, even though it makes it a little more difficult. We've been on both sides of that, whether it's the NCAA tournament or hosting our own games and events. And there's really pressure both ways. I think people don't understand that. If you're not playing well and the crowd's against you, that's tough. if you're not playing well and the crowd's not helping you from a home team perspective, that's tough too. And we've been on both sides of those. So, but I think this time of year, atmosphere is a big, big part of the experience, and we're pleased that we'll have a good atmosphere tomorrow.
Next question. Matt?
Coach Matt, KSFY, when you're traveling something like this, you're kind of at the mercy of the NCAA when you guys can get chartered out here. That whole day on Tuesday leading up for the travel day, are you trying to keep your kids at bay, not really knowing when you're going to leave, how you're going to get there? Did it maybe take a wear and tear on them? What was it kind of feeling like?
Yeah, I think having been through it for a lot of years really settles everybody's mind, to be honest with you. Having gone through it for this now our 6th year, you kind of know what to expect. And so even though we didn't have exact details, we can kind of talk about what the day is going to be like, how flexible our team needs to be, coaches need to be. You know, we really told them we could be leaving yesterday anywhere from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m., you know, and they'll have to plan accordingly. So I don't know that that was a big negative, to be honest with you. We're still here a day earlier than we normally travel, so today is going to be pretty restful. We'll have a good practice, hopefully, but they'll have plenty of time to get their feet under them.
Question.
AJ, you guys have been to, I was doing a roadmap here yesterday when we were coming out. Texas, Oklahoma, Colorado, Ohio, Indiana, and now Oregon. You kind of look at this as being something kind of a fun, can you look at it as being a fun road trip for your team?
Yeah, I think so. You're just so focused on what you want to do, though, you just don't really probably enjoy some of the things you normally would if you're just kind of coming out. I think it's fun to experience new places. I absolutely do. From my perspective, I know our players really enjoy that. You know, we'll play in an arena that has a ton of history and a place that our players would never probably play in unless it's something like this. So there's a lot of positive takeaways from that, too. We've got SDSU fans in this part of the country that probably never had a chance to see us play unless we were out here, you know, so that's an opportunity for them, too. So it's a great chance, no doubt about it, but what makes it memorable is to play well. You know, that's what makes a trip somewhere really good, when you can think back and have a positive outcome. And so that's more the focus, and sometimes that focus takes away from just enjoying it probably a little more than we should.
So, David
Brown again. Your freshman and sophomores, for both of those classes, this is their first NCAA tournament. Mm-hmm. From your past experiences, do you treat them any differently than the upperclassmen in preparing them for this tournament?
No, I don't treat them differently. Better or worse, you know, expectations at this point are really high, and we expect them to play at a high level. We don't approach this game any differently than some of the games we've played here recently come conference tournament time. You know, they need to perform. If we're going to play well, those young players need to perform. And I think if we introduced a different way of coaching them or interacting to them, that almost adds to the you know, anxiety of knowing it's a big moment. So, you know, we've run a lot of things early in games for certain players, and we're going to run those same things for those players. Some of them are seniors, some of them are freshmen, and that's because we expect them to do well in the game.
How important is it to get a win tomorrow?
I think it's really important, not because it's any extra urgency or any extra expectation tomorrow versus any other day, NCAA tournament day I'm talking about, but when you get chances to play in this event, you ought to make the most of them. I think a lot of people in our world, you know, 6 out of 7 years, seem like this is just kind of the norm and the way it always goes. It just doesn't. There are a lot of programs that very rarely get a chance to play in the NCAA tournament. So we don't want to take, you know, that idea for granted. We want to try and maximize that opportunity. The only way you do that is to win games. And it's not just one game. It's advancing and trying to make a run. And every year we have the same chance. And it doesn't mean that it's, you know, who you play and where you play any easier, any harder. It's going to be hard, you know, no matter what. And playing a good team is going to make that difficult, but that's the goal, and I'm sure it's Oregon State's goal too. You know, they want to maximize what they've done this year, and certainly moving forward in the tournament is really what they, I'm sure, need to do to take that next step too. So both of us have the same motivation. Maybe we're in a little different places, but the motivation is the same.
Coach Drew Carroll from the SDSU Collegian. Can you kind of give some comment about having been in the tournament 6 times already and kind of what advantages that brings with it?
I think there are just a lot of differences for being in the NCAA tournament. not how we prepare or practice, but logistics, timing, just kind of little nuances that you never have in a regular season game. And I think those things can throw a big wrench or distraction into a team's preparation. A practice today, for instance, can have a little more chaos surrounding it versus just a normal practice in Frost. And just being able to explain this is how it's going to go, and here's how we combat that, and here's how we try and minimize those things, I think that helps. I think having been in a tournament, won a game, having lost a few times, having had some other postseason experience with the WNIT and having success, all of those things, I think, give us a chance to play well, you know, using all those past experiences. So hopefully it shows up tomorrow.
Question. Excuse me. Gonna have to shoot the three well in this game.
We're going to have to shoot well regardless. You look at Oregon State's defensive numbers, their offensive numbers are phenomenal. I mean, they score a lot of points from a lot of different positions. They can play fast, they can play slow, they have a ton of offensive weapons, but I don't know that people talk enough about it. They're really good defensively. They just don't give you a lot of easy shots. And again, I think it goes back to your earlier question, it's just that length. And it's not always blocking shots, that's part of it, but like I said, just the length in a passing lane, it's the length trying to make a pass into the post, it's just that length everywhere. They're a pretty straightforward defensive team. They don't, you know, throw a ton of things at you, but they play incredibly hard. They're in the right spots all the time. They just have a real urgency to what they do defensively. So we're going to have to make shots, whether it's threes, inside. We're going to have to get to the free throw line. We're going to have to find ways to score against a good defensive team. Yeah.
Any further questions for Coach?
Yeah,
Scott.
Hey, Scott with Jackrabbit Sports Network. Do you look at your schedule and see a similarity? Does Oregon State look like a DePaul, or does it look like a
Yeah, I think bits and pieces of Oregon State look like bits and pieces of other teams, but the difference is we could take out the strengths of all the really top teams we played this year, and now you put all those bits and pieces on one team. You know, that's the big challenge. Oregon State has a lot going for it right now. Really one of the best point guards in the country. I mean, she is phenomenal, phenomenal player. And then around her, they've got some great players that all shoot the ball and get to the basket and post up. And so they're really, you take the best of all the teams we've played and kind of put them together, and that's what makes Oregon State. That's why it's a big challenge. But I do think we're playing at a high level right now, too, for us. And I like where our team is at. I like how we've played. The game will kind of sort itself out tomorrow, but I feel good about where we're at and feel good about how we'll play, too.
Any further questions for Coach?
All right. Thanks.
Again, tomorrow's game between Oregon State and South Dakota State, 2 p.m. The Jackrabbits will be on the floor for practice at 1:10. Practice is open to the media for the first 15 minutes. Our next press conference will be at 2 p.m. with the George Washington Clones. Thank you.